all use language to communicate with our fellow humans.
But when you want to tell the world you mean business, it's your vocabulary that can distinguish you or extinguish you.
Jimmy Rhodes looks at some ways to boost your word power at the top of the list.
There are lots of words. So if you're using awesome for the Grand Canyon and for that stack of waffles at IHOP, you're doing something wrong.
We've gotten used to using words like awesome that are very safe and easy because they fit quickly in social media posts.
Career expert Carrie Sanderson says better words should be part of your career strategy.
Having a great vocabulary builds your credibility and builds your professional image.
So I Googled words to make you sound smarter and then tried them out on Carrie. I traded in lazy for perfunctory.
Nobody knows what that means.
And I ditched suck up for sycophant.
That's a way of insulting someone without them knowing it.
And instead of confuse, I tried obfuscate.
That's a good one because it is a confusing word itself.
This isn't going well.
I would not use any of those words.
But they're from the internet.
You'll alienate people if you try to use big intellectual words when something simple and clear can articulate your idea better.
There's a middle ground between everything either being lame or awesome and showing off with $10 words. Here's how to build a working vocabulary that will actually help you at work. For starters, sign up for Word of the Day emails.
I actually have a folder in my email where I keep those words of the day and go back and look at them when I'm trying to write something and I get a little bit stuck. It's always a great reference.
Next, shut your yap and learn to listen.
To become a better speaker, you should become a better listener.
Go to school on people with a knack for communicating.
Most of the time we listen to respond, but when you listen to really hear, you can pick up some great words.
You don't want to lose those great words, so carry a notebook, because pen on paper will work better than your smartphone for retention.
Highly recommend that you actually handwrite it. That helps create muscle memory, so you will retain the word a little bit better.
Also, take notes on how to say it.
It could be a little bit of a disaster to try out a new word and not pronounce it correctly.
Like when I asked a guy at Trader Joe's where to find the acai bowls. Finally, to lock in a new word, use it or lose it.
You should try to use a new word a couple of times a day in conversation just to become more comfortable with it.
Using a new word transfers it from a concept into your working vocabulary. So use your words. Building a vocabulary for success is at the top of the list.